check this bad boy out. Look at all that storage space. Here's the golden bag holding. Okay, if I can click on something that's not going to... That's the golden bag holding, which is really cool. Don't get me wrong, but check this out. I carry this with me. Storage, never an issue again.
You can actually ever see
little mini blocks. Little mini blocks. And you can just do
and we're just
designs.
Gonna hop on it.
Oh! Hey, what's going on, guys? We are back on the Revenge of the C-Team server. And today, I have to tell you, I don't know if it's going to be short. I don't know if it's going to be long. We'll see how fast we can get everything done. But oh my god, I found some cool stuff. I've been playing around with some of the mods, searching for like new stuff that I've never seen before. And I came across one today, and I'm just going to really like jump right into it. Because this thing that I found is absolutely awesome. It's right here. It's called the Builder, right? Really, really simple. I need 2 levers, 6 iron, and a chest, right? Now, this is going to be exciting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do I have any levers? Sure had some. Oh, no. As a matter of fact, I just used my last 2 levers. So I need... do I have 6? Yes, I got 6. 1, 2. And cobble. 1, 2. And what else did I need? A chest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, this thing is awesome. So I've been dealing with, like, you know, storage issues, like always. And I was trying to figure out a way... Why do I only have 1 stick? I called for 2. I did. I called for 2. Stick. Come on. And I've been trying to figure out a way, like, you know, maybe carry a little bit more on me and stuff like that, right? Oh, I am so excited about this thing. Okay, so there's all these, like, better storage mods and stuff like that. And there's Java and, you know, all those fun things. Whatever. What is that thing, by the way? Extra utility. Super Builder's one and Builder's... I can make that. Unstable with an obsidian. I can't make that one. I'm curious as to what this is. We might have to check that out later. But that's not what we're doing right now. We are making this bad boy right here. Oh, hold on. What are you? Iron plate for Abyssalcraft? I've never seen that before. I wonder what that goes with. Anyways. Chest there. Levers here. Iron here. All right. Now... I know I'm going to need a ton of iron. I'm going to grab all these iron bars because I'm going to need a lot of them. I'm going to grab some wool because I'm going to need, I'm thinking like a whole stack of these. We might do 2. We might even do 3. Yeah, we'll do 3. I need some string, which I know I got plenty of. We'll go ahead and grab a couple stacks of those as well. And chests. I'm going to have to make a whole bunch of chests. Yes, so let's just grab all of this and see how many I can make at the moment. Okay, so this thing is freaking awesome. You know what? I might as well grab those iron ingots while I'm at it, too. I know I got more outside in my blacksmith area, but it's okay. So we're going to make as many chests as we can right now. I don't know exactly how many I'm going to need, but okay, this thing is freaking awesome. I'm going to go set this up in the blacksmith because that's where all my iron is at, and that is the major supply I'm going to need. Yeah, so here's the deal, right? Storage is always an issue. We know this. I mean, it's, you know, it's modded Minecraft. Storage is always an issue. Sorry, I'm looking around trying to figure out. I'm going to put them right there because this is the builder, right? This can make chests. Any one of these 4 colors. Oh, clay. I need clay. Ooh, clay. It can make it any one of those 4 colors that I was just showing you. And you can increase the size of your chest to your desire. Now, that is freaking awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. 93. Okay, that should be plenty. Right? So, I don't even know how to, I'm so excited. I found this thing and I was like, oh my god, this is freaking amazing. This will so solve so much, or so many storage issues. It's just going to be awesome, right? So we're going to make our first chest. So I'm going to go ahead and put a stack there. I don't think I can put any more now. I'm going to put a stack of iron. And know it. What I need to make is more iron bars. All right. Now I got plenty. Cool. And I'm going to go ahead and grab a stack of iron here. All right. So I'm gonna put a chest in there, some iron bars in there, and oh, sorry, iron ingots and iron bars in there, right? So I'm gonna just go as big as possible, right? We're gonna go 24 columns and 12 rows. Watch this. Build chest. Come on. Build chest. Oh, I didn't pick a color. Build chest. Why aren't you working? Why aren't you working? I got all clay, iron. Hold on. Is this going to be more expensive than I thought it was? Oh, I need more chest. That's why I can't build it. Okay. Let's go get some wood. Oh, you know what? I have tons of redwood in there. I should be able to make chests out of redwood, right? I mean, it's a lot of materials. I'm going to go ahead and give you that. It is a lot of materials. I think I can make chests out of redwood. Oh, I should not have called for them all. Let me see real quick. Can I make chests out of redwood? Yes, I can. And these make four chests each? Oh, my God. Riven, I've been doing that with the redwood this whole time. Oh, that is awesome. Can you do that with logs? Can you make four chests with eight logs? Ooh, that's curious now. Okay, cool. Build chest. Yeah, so it takes, what was it, 18? 18 chests, all the iron, and 18 clay. But now I've got this, oh, it's white though. I wanted to make it blue. It's okay, I can make more. Check this bad boy out. Look at all that storage space. It's so beautiful. It is so beautiful. I would use my axe, but I don't have a regular axe. So the reason I was looking for more storage space is because look at this, right? All my materials here have kind of gotten crazy, right? They're getting a little out of hand. So I'm going to go ahead and swap out. Oh, you know what? Let me grab you real quick. Because I can put a ton of stuff in you. But I'm not going to use that for very long. And I'll show you why after we do this. Okay. Oh, I want you. There we go. And let's go grab some more of this stuff. Oh my God. Look at the size. Did you see how huge that chest is? It's freaking amazing. Like that is. I mean, I don't think any other mod even comes close to a chest size like that. Like, that is insane. Absolutely insane. Okay, here we go. So, yeah, I'm just going to break these chests real quick. And you'll actually see some pipes down here. I've automated my smeltery a little bit. Actually, I'm not even going to... Whoa. I'm not even going to need you anymore. There we go. Pshoom. I'm going to need to get another brick, though. But check this out. Blugook. I think it connects. I didn't actually check to see if this thing connects. It does. All right. And now I can just fill it with all this stuff again. And it just auto-sorts like everything else. Is that not, like, freaking sweet? If you guys don't think that is sweet, y'all are crazy. Like, absolutely crazy. I think that is just absolutely amazing. And the best part is, and you're going to see the best part in a second, because I'm sure you saw the button that I saw. That's iron, right? Yeah. Not only does it just chest, it does backpacks too, so I can have a carry-along that is this big. It's freaking sick. It is so sick. There we go. Let me organize real quick. Oh, goodness gracious. I'm so pumped up right now. I'm going to do this real quick just to keep that out of the way. Wait, why don't I put you there? That would make more sense, huh? All right. Let's get all this put away. Like, look, I literally just turned a double chest into barely even, not even two rows, maybe two rows. A little over two rows. That's a double chest right there. That is freaking sick. That is so sick. And manilium. Oops, this chest. Like that. Now, check it. I'm going to switch it over and make a backpack, right? Just take that out, throw some wool in there. I'm going to need a stack of iron ingots. And what was the other part? Oh, bars. I got those, right? I got 60 bars. Iron ingots. I need to make more bars? I thought I had bars. Did I not have enough bars? It's okay. I can make some more with iron ingots, right? Yes. Bingo bango. I'm just going to make a ton of bars. Because I have a feeling I'm going to be making a lot of these chests. I know I had a lot of those. I don't know what happened to them all. Anyways. 64, 64, 64. But instead of clay, it's string. We're going to make it a blue backpack. And we're going to build this bad boy. Check this out. I carry this thing. So here's the golden bag of holding. Okay, if I can click on something that's not going to... That's the golden bag of holding, which is really cool. Don't get me wrong. But check this out. I carry this with me. Storage, never an issue again. Ever. And then I can put a backpack inside a backpack inside. Never an issue again. I will never have to worry about what I'm carrying ever again. Why? So check this out. Just putting all this stuff in here until the next time I want to make one. Because I'm not worried about it. Oh, that is so freaking amazing. I don't need the golden bag of holding anymore. I mean, tell me. I want to know if you guys how amazing that is. These are huge. Absolutely huge. Now, granted, like I said, it takes a lot of material. I mean, it's a full stack of iron bars and a full stack of iron ingots, which basically, that's a lot of iron. But, you know, a little bit of wool, a little bit of string, a little bit of chest, a little bit of clay. I don't know about you. I think it's worth it. I think that is so worth it. There are no words for how worth it it is. Like, oh my God. Is that an awesome? That's going to bother me. I need to go get a stone block. But anyways, so storage issues are never going to be an issue again because I'm pretty sure I haven't made another one yet, but I'm pretty sure I can hook it up to my item system. I don't know if I've ever showed you my item system there, but I mean, look at all these chests. They hold a lot. Don't get me wrong, but I can go make... Like, what, 4 or 5 of those to probably be equivalent to all of this? Like, it's crazy. Now, I don't know if they hook up to the inventory system, but I think it's like, I mean, I figure if the thermal dynamic stuff or whichever mod that is, thermal, whatever, hooks up, I think this should be able to hook up too. Compact storage, guys, look it up. It's freaking awesome. Now, I did find another one I just want to show you real quick because I want to get into some redstone builds. I really do like redstone builds. And this little guy right here, pretty cheap to make. Some lapis, some ink sacks, a gold nugget, an iron bar, and some wool. Like, really, really simple. And I think I should have enough. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. Some wool. We'll just grab this one right here. A gold nugget. Haha, I do have nuggets. Cool. And iron bars. I can go grab those. They're in the... Let me grab all this wood and put it back. Oh, so many chests. I mean, I live in a redwood tree, and we now see that this makes 4. Oh, good grief. This is so amazing. But the little blocks mod, right? This one is really, really fun and really, really cool. And I'm so excited about it, too, because I still didn't make that stone block. Okay. I know I'm getting sidetracked here, but I'm telling you, I literally just found these maybe an hour ago. And as soon as I found him, I was like, dude, I am so excited to get this episode done. So I wanted to go organize like all my stuff in Stonebrick. There we go. The blacksmith. So I was pumping all the fluids out. So my smelter is actually empty right now. And that is by design because there's another thing I want to do. And I don't know if I should do it this episode because it could make this episode really, really long. But I think it's totally worth it. So I'm kind of willing to do it. Look at that. Look at that. Iron ingot. There we go. And I think that was everything, right? Wand. Oh, I didn't get the lapis. I did not get the lapis. Okay, but I got the iron ingot down, so I grabbed that, yeah. And that is, I found a new way to teleport like around the map and stuff like that. And it's pretty freaking sweet. It's pretty, I'm not going to say end game kind of stuff, but I mean, it's later in there. You're not going to be able to do this, you know, right off the bat or anything like that. But it's a way for me to condense that entire... this thing is awesome. Okay. Let me just grab some vanilla blocks because I had some issues before with this. So I'm just going to grab some vanilla blocks. We'll grab some cobble. It's so cute. This thing is so cute. Anyways, what was I talking about? Oh, yeah, about teleporting and stuff like that, right? We've got that teleport room, and we haven't gone to the end yet, and there's actually a reason for that, because I haven't made an end chest, and I just haven't gotten around to making an ender chest, but then I found out that I can make this new teleporter, and so I think it's going to happen. Because I can create another one, and I can put different ones in there. I've got the End, I've got my Erebus, I've got my ones to the Abyssal Wasteland, but I can also now go to the Dreadlands straight from here. I can go to the Lost Millennium straight from here. Like, I am going to put one everywhere. I mean, that's just the way it goes. And we're going to do this episode. So, guys, I'm going to go ahead and let you know it's going to be a long episode. I have a feeling it's going to be a pretty long episode. How long? I'm not exactly sure, but it's going to be a long one. But we're going to go play with this guy real quick, and I don't know where I want to do this because I'm not doing anything specific other than just kind of demonstrating this thing. But I want this specifically for some redstone work. So, you know what? We'll just go ahead and put it by the Abyssal Craft little thing over here. All right, so I'm just going to right-click. And now you can see I'm kind of like doing little small blocks inside. And this is awesome. You can actually, and you see, little mini blocks. And you can just do little designs. And it's an 8x8 area. So technically speaking, if I were to do, look at the S. I'm probably going to do some writing on walls and stuff like this. I think that's probably the most useful thing I can think of right now without necessarily doing redstone. But, I mean, if you think about it, you can represent an entire chunk like this with a 4x4, or sorry, 2x2x2. And look at this. This is just so cute. And it just lets me keep stacking higher and higher and higher and higher. It's violated everything. And it just keeps going. Like, we can make, like, little mini structures. I can, like, decorate my own house. Like, you know, make a little house and stuff like that. And, like, make a little obstacle course and makes you feel like a big old giant. Right? Is this not cool? Like, I don't know, guys. There are some really cool mods in this mod pack. And I am absolutely loving it right now. But look at that. There's 64 block shoes right there, man. And just this little area. And then what's really cool, if I break it, I can break, like, you know, one by one by one, I think. Or I can break the whole thing, I think. Yeah. If I'm not hitting on a specific block, it'll just break the whole thing down. And just give me all my blocks back. I think it's freaking awesome. I don't know what you guys think, but I think that's pretty freaking awesome. I'm going to have so much fun with that. But anyways, yeah. So, now to the teleporting issue, right? Now, this actually... Oh, goodness. Okay, yeah. We are going to make one real quick. I know I can make... Well, I'm going to make two. I'm going to make two just to put one in the Nether for right now. And then I'll probably make the rest off camera. And we'll start putting them up in the next episode. But, this is awesome. So, I found this guy right here, right? It's called Teleporter Plate. And basically what it is, it's a hardened energy cell, 4 Enderium ingots, 3 bronze ingots, and this guy, right? A translocation plate. Translocation plate can be made by filling it with resident ender, and it just takes, I think that's 10 ender pearls worth. And then this plate, which is signilium, hardened glass, invar, and I think I have some hardened glass. So we're going to make two of these, right? So I need two hardened glass. The Invar and the Signilium we're going to make over in the blacksmith. Enderium's over in the blacksmith. Bronze over in the blacksmith. The hardened, okay? This is what I got to make. So I'm going to need some more Invar ingots. And then I'm going to need some copper ingots, a leadstone energy cell frame, and electrum and redstone. Cool. And this one is lead thickened glass and a redstone block. So I'm going to need two of these. Do I have any thickened glass? No, I used it all. What is the recipe for thickened glass? Wait, was it this one? Yeah, thickened glass. Oh, that's hardened glass. What was I making? What was I needing thickened glass for? Oh, for this guy. For this guy. Oh, no, it's just regular glass. Lead. Oh, it was like any kind of glass. Okay, so I'm going to need 8 glass, 8 lead. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the lead is over there. The redstone. I think I already grabbed two of those, but let's grab two more just in case. the hardened glass I got. 8 got that. How do you make that? Hardened glass, I got 2. Invar, vanillium. This guy right here is made like that. 4 glass. Okay, cool. Hold on. I keep doing this and I forget what else I need. I'm going to need to grab some redstone. So I'm going to need 4 redstone. And that's it. All the rest of the metals are over there. So 4 of these. And I should have everything. All right. So I'm going to make a couple of these frames. All right. I just want to kill you because I hear you. Where you at? I hear a skeleton. Y'all hear that skeleton? I don't know. Anyways. So I'm going to need some electrum, which I got. I need 2 ingots of that. So I need to make 2 of these. Right. There we go. And okay, what else is in the frame? Okay, this is the frame right here. So I need 8 lead. Lead. It's like a bluish metal, right? Yeah. So I'm going to need 8 lead. Bingo bango. And do that. There we go. 2 of those. Good. The frames are done. Then, oh, I can click on this guy. That's a lot easier. There we go. And then Invar. I need 8 Invar. I got 1 there, but I got Invar block. Yeah, there we go. I was like, I knew I got blocks around here somewhere. So there we go. And you. Oh, no, not you. You. Like that. Do I have to put him in there like this? Harden energy cell frame. There we go. And with copper and those 2. Okay, so I need 6 copper. Copper, there we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm taking a guess you don't autofill, so we'll put you there, and it was like that, right? Hardening energy cell. Alright, cool. So we've got 2 of those. Alright. Then we need Enderium, bronze, and then the plate. And the plate is made like so, with hardened glass, invar, and sedilium. Okay, this is the one I have to make. This I have none of. I've made it once before, I think. But it's a mixture of redstone, copper, and silver. So it's 1 copper. How many ingots? That gives me 4 ingots. Okay. So I need to make 2 of these, right? 2 of these is what I need to make? Yeah, because I need 4. So we're going to have to do this twice. Okay, cool. So, shoot, I gotta go back to that recipe. Signilium. Oh, ingots right there. Cool. Bink, bink, bink. So I'm gonna need 2 silver. I'm going to need 6 copper and 20 redstone. Silver. I got so much shiny block now. So I'm gonna need 2 silver, 6 copper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. And then 10 redstone. Okay. So let's just break these down real quick. 1, 2. And we'll put that 1 invar ingot back and the other 7 back. And redstone. Did I already use those or did I have 2 extra? I've got 2 extra. So I can just break those down. Except that's only going to give me 18. And really? And I'm going to need 2 more. Alright, so we'll go get 2 more redstone. And we'll throw it all in the induction smelter thingy-majig. Not induction smelter, sorry. The smeltery. Yeah, that thing. And redstone. 2 more of those. Oh, I am so pumped. I am so pumped about that storage thing. Like, that storage thing is easily the coolest thing I found so far. That is a huge, huge chest. And an absolutely enormous backpack. Like, that is insane. Look at the size. It's a backpack. That is so sick. I don't care what you say. That is sick. Okay, so 20 of those in there. 2 silver in there. Now, this should make the Signilium. Should. And I can also show you how I kind of automated this thing over here. So these guys over here, I'm actually going to turn them to... Oh, I don't want them to be on weak. I might just do this one manually. All right, the redstone's in there. See, that's 2,000. Okay, so there's more than enough. And then that copper should finish up, and I should have at least 8 ingots worth of this Signilium stuff. If I did my math right. Hopefully I did my math right. There we go. Conductive red metal. Liquid redstone. Silver copper. Why isn't it giving me my Signilium? It gave me 3 ingots of conductive red metal. That should have given me... It was copper, right? It wasn't bronze. It was copper. No, not you. You. How do you make Signilium? Destabilize redstone. I wonder. I'm really, really curious that because maybe it didn't make destabilize redstone. Maybe I gotta pump that in. Because that is just liquid redstone. That's not the same. Let me go get some destabilize. I know I've got... I mean, if all else fails, I can just pump more in there. Not a big deal. I know I have a portable tank because I just cleared it out of my... Which is in there? Oh yeah, it's got plenty. Cement. I just pumped it out of my fluid... What's the thing called? The thermal expansion one that melts stuff down, turns stuff into liquids, make, you know, the glowstone and all that stuff. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and where's my hammer? There it is. I'm going to pull you off real quick. There we go. And I'm going to put you on here. Oh, I can't because of the redstone there. So I'm going to put you right here. All right. And do a little clicky click with the hammer. So I'll turn you off. There we go. Pump you back in. Okay, cool. Did that make any Signilium? Molten copper, destabilized redstone, silver, liquid redstone. Oh, I'm going to have to add more copper. And, okay, the 2 ingots of silver still in there, so I just need copper, 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 copper. How many do I already have in there? I have 1, and I needed 6, so what am I doing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, hopefully, this makes... Because I've got destabilized redstone in there now. Yes. Cool, cool, cool. So, hopefully, this makes the Signilium. Hoping. Hoping, hoping, hoping. If it does, this is cool, though. This little thing right here. Oh, it's so sweet. And I think I'm going to have to go make a couple more energy cells, actually. Because it has to power it. Or I'll put 1 by my power station for right now, and then we'll... Maybe a Tesseract? Maybe that could come in the next episode of Tesseract. So I can power them remotely. Go in. More conductive. Liquefied. Silver. Okay, I gotta get this stuff out. That's what I gotta do. Let me get this liquefied redstone out of there. Here, go. There you go. Drained it all out. Just collect you guys real quick. And put you like that. And disconnect you guys. I can pick you back up too. Alright. Alright, 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 alright. So what's in here now? I got silver. I've got conductive red metal. And I've got destabilized redstone. Okay, let me get this stuff out of here. This makes these... Yeah, these really cool ingots actually. It's I believe these are the ones I'm used. Yeah, it is. To make the red wire that I just pulled down or broke off a second ago. It's pretty cool stuff. Doesn't have... Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. It's okay. So we're going to put you back in there. I've got the destabilized redstone. I've got the silver. Let me get 6 more copper ingots. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll go ahead and put you in there and smelt up. Now, hopefully this works. Right? Because it said, I had 2,400 millibuckets. It said it needed... I need this stuff. Oops. It needed how much? Needs a... Yeah. So I've got more than enough. Okay, so silver's in. Copper's going in. Destabilized redstone's in. And this should work. This should work. Give me signillium. There it is. 8 ingots. Perfect. All right. So we've got our 8 ingots of this. Is it signillium? Yeah, that's what I'm going to call it. It's signillium. Signillum? Signillum, maybe? Signillum? Signillum? I don't know. Name's not really all that important now, is it? And I think I need a more invar, too, to make these plates. And then I'm going to have to go fill it with ender fluid stuff. Resident ender, I think it is. Come on. There we go. Okay, that's everything. And see what's left in there. Oh, like 400 millibucks, that stuff. That's cool. And I'm going to need some invar. Where's my invar at? Let me just grab a whole block here. Break that down. And let me make sure I got everything I need. Let me go to the recipe here. I want to make this plate. How do I make that? Like that. There we go. 2 plates. Good. And then I have to go fill it with resident ender, which I can do really, really easy. I just got to grab some ender pearls and head over to the... Why can I not remember the name of... Let me just grab... How many is there? Oh, no, that's too many. I'm going to grab 2 stacks. Go. Oh, man. I'm shaking right now. I get so excited with some of the stuff. Like, there's some really cool stuff that you can do. And, you know, it's just a matter of really playing with the mod and all, but... How do I... Don't I just... Oh, I gotta put in this thing first. There we go. You're gonna pump into there, right? Fill that chamber. There we go. Okay, cool. All right. And then I'm gonna put you there. There. Oh, cool. It doesn't take much at all. 1,000 maybe? That is so sick. So now we got these translocation plates. And then the translocation plate gets wrapped in enderium and bronze and those 2 cells. All right. We got this. Got this. And you know what? I'm going to look up a resident energy cell too, just to check it out. I know it doesn't really need that much, but we'll look up cell. Because you know what? I need a couple of these anyway. So enderium's good. Okay, so I'm going to have to make some of this redstone stuff. The frame is electrum, diamond, and hardened glass. Okay, cool. That's easy. Hardened glass. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what was it? And a diamond. I've got that. Easy. And now the electrum and that. Okay, cool. We got this. Enderium. I think I should have enough. I made quite a bit before this episode. Yeah, that's like, what, 8 blocks? Yeah, I think that should be... Hey. That should be enough. Yeah, that's like a stack. Over a stack. Yeah. And bronze. Bronze. Bronze is an alloy, huh? Oh, cool. But I've got a whole block there. So, sweet. And like that. And wrap you up like that. Bingo bango. And wrap you up like that. We've got our plates. Oh, now I need... Oh, electrum. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it was diamond in the middle. Electrum in the corners. Hardened glass like that. Yep. And let's go get some redstone to fill this bad boy up. And then we will wrap it in. Oh, I should grab the enderium while I'm here. I think it was just 4 Enderium, right? Oh, I have the Enderium. Jeez. It's on me. I'm running around with this portable tank here. So we'll grab some redstone. Oh, good thing I'm carrying the portable tank, actually. Because I'm going to have to take that ender stuff out of there. I don't know exactly how much I'm going to need, so I'll make sure I grab enough. Perfect 20. That's kind of cool. Alright. So go back over to the... whatever that thing's called. Why can't I not remember the name of it? Fluid Transposer was the one I was thinking of the name of. And magma? Magma Crucible, yeah. So we're going to stick you in there. You're going to fill that tank up real quick. I'm going to go ahead and throw you on here. So you push all that in there. Cool. And now, do that. There you go. Fill you up. How much is it? How much is it to make that tank? Redstone frame full. It is 4,000. I'm probably going to need like another 20 redstone. I have a feeling that's the number I need. Woo! I don't know about you guys, but I'm digging this. I think this is really cool. You guys, let me know what you think. Like, I mean, seriously, your opinions really do matter. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I really do take the time to try to respond as much as I can. And if you guys come up with some awesome ideas, dude, I'm all about trying them out and, you know, trying new things. And hopefully now that you guys are seeing like this new stuff, maybe you didn't know about this. But, you know, so you learned something new and then you can teach me more new stuff and then I can keep doing. And it's just an awesome, well, people call it a vicious cycle, but I think it's a pretty awesome cycle, actually. All right, so... then I wrap that in Enderium, and we get the Resonant Energy Cell frame. Oh, I still got more to do to it. Okay, then just wrap it in Enderium, lead, and another one of those. Cool. So I'll grab 2 more redstone as I run over. And we'll be able to make this thing. What is this? An emerald box. Oh, a chiseled emerald box. That looks really pretty, actually. A technical battery? Interesting. All right, so let's go ahead and make this guy here. Sweet. So now we got the frame. And then it's just electrum, lead, and the little thing, which is 1 electrum and some redstone. So 1, 2. I don't have any electrum on me, do I? Nope. I'm going to drop this cobblestone just because I don't need it right now, and it's kind of filling my inventory, and it doesn't make me happy that way. All right, and back over here. This and over there should be closer. I know now as I've ran back and forth like 5 or 6 times. But hey, what are you going to do? So 1 and then 1, 2, 3. And lead, it was 1, 2. Okay, cool. I think that should be enough. I hope I did that right. Oh, it is shape crafting. Redstone coil like that. You there. And you? Yes! Resident Energy Cell, how much does this hold? Holds 80 million RF. Yeah, that will keep a charge for a while. I knew that thing was pretty powerful and all. I didn't know how powerful, or, you know, how much power it held. That's a lot of power. But, oh, I'm so excited to try this thing out. Hey, get back here. What was I doing here? I ran over here for a reason. Oh, yeah, I ran to this. So I can charge this bad boy up like really quickly. You go there and charge you up. Look how fast that feels. Oh, that takes 12,000 RF per tick is what it puts out. That is crazy. Does this even have cobble? Oh man, I don't even have any cobblestone left in there. It's a matter dust. Oh my goodness. Like, I don't even know how long it would take to use 80 million RF. I have a feeling it would take a while. Just assuming. And I know this thing holds an RF charge of like... oh, I gotta make the multimeter. Ha, I'm glad I looked at that. MULTI multimeter. This guy? Thermal expansion, yes. Oops. What's the recipe for you? Two copper, two lead, another one of those, and a gear, which is iron and four electrum. Okay. I can make that pretty easy. I mean, look how fast this is filling the cell up. And I was also told that I can use this as my battery for, what's this thing called? For matter overdrive. So I actually can make an 80 million RF battery, which is a little bit better than the 1.05 one that I'm using right now. And I think that would last a pretty darn long time. I know it would, actually. So I think that's pretty freaking sweet. So we're almost there. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I just don't want to have to do this more than once. And eventually I think I'll end up probably doing a tesseract. But for right, you know what? Yeah, we're going to go ahead and pull you now because that's enough. If I set you right here, will you get a charge? Yes, it already has a charge. Cool. So let's go make the multimeter. And then we can head to the nether and put this other one in the nether. So I can make a whole bunch of these. And I may do that. I may kind of mass produce them. I need a little bit more redstone. I needed one more of those coil things. So I need a little bit more redstone. Redstone. And then like I can put them in different places in the nether and just kind of name them. And once I make the multimeter, that'll make more sense. Because if you've ever set up a tesseract before, you can set up like, you know, different locations and stuff to send things to certain places, get stuff from certain places, whatever. And electrum, there's five of those ingots. Hey, I knew you were going to come in here. I knew you were going to try that. Back off my awesome new katana blade here. Hey, I hear another spider. Where are you? I don't know. Multimeter, this is what we're making. I need to make the gear. Oh, so I need an iron ingot. Iron, there we go. And, oh, that's gold. That's electrum. Oh, wow, yeah, I got plenty of electrum. And, oh, yeah, and then I need to make you like dish. Bingo, bango. And you guys go like this with the iron bar in the middle. And that should be good, right? I should have everything. Oh, no, I need lead and what was the other metal? Was that a little metal right there? Copper. Two copper, two lead. One, two. One, two. I'm going to put, I don't need the invar. That doesn't go in there. There's other Etenderium, bronze. Yeah, okay, cool. So multimeter, make you. Awesome. And for right now, this is just going to be a temporary home. This is not going to be the permanent home for this thing. But I'm going to leave it there because it gets a constant charge from the power station. So might as well just leave it like that for right now. I don't want to have to make another one at the moment. Oh, why am I putting everything but what I want in my hotbar? So do this, and then we're gonna name this one home, and give it a little name like that. Sweet. And power is gonna be on ignore, so it's always on. And now we're gonna head to the nether and drop this little bad boy in the nether. And I can actually not have to worry about flying home from spawn every single time anymore, which, I mean, it's not bad because I've got the TF2 teleporter over there, but now if I,
it'd be that much sweeter.
So where are we going to put this thing? Let's go into bat mode here. I'm thinking I might go put it over, might go put it over by the nether fortress that I always go to. That I always lose my way to because I've yet to remember to put a waypoint there. But I know it's over here somewhere. A little laggy in the nether right now. Kind of interested about that. I know the nether fortress is around here somewhere. Oh, there's one of those boats. Okay, so in an upcoming episode, we are going to be taking a trip. I found out, I think I've mentioned it before, this little Ondu statue here, Ondu statue, is actually a portal to fossils and archaeology. There it is. Fossils and archaeology location. That's pretty sweet. So we're going to go ahead and just put you in right here. All right. Put you like that. Top needs to be for out. think like that, right? Maybe the other color's out? Is blue out? Blue's not out, is it? Nope. It's that other color. It's orange. That's out. There you go. That's filling that up nicely. Okay. And I'll go ahead and put that block there. And then we're going to go and take our multimeter here and call this one the Nether Fortress. And give it a name. And then we're going to say, I want to go home. And it's going to do some cool sparkly stuff. And we're just going to hop on it. Oh! All right, so I had a little lag issue. The server was in the middle of a backup as I was coming through. That's kind of funny. But I'm here! It's daytime. That's sweet. So it works. It freaking works. Oh, guys, I'm so excited. This is freaking awesome. Jumping for joy. And then I can go make one of those cells. I really want to kind of check out that cell concept. So maybe I'll do that in the next episode or in between episodes. But apparently, this cell, this little battery cell that I use here, which is actually filling as I'm standing here, actually, I can use a thermal expansion cell. So I think that's pretty freaking sweet. And we're definitely going to try that out. But until next time, guys, I am Slider Havoc. This is our Revenge of the Sea Team server. And I am out of here. Peace. Oh, wait. I always forget to say this. Comment, like, subscribe. Y'all know the deal. Have a good one. Peace.